Let's see how to install Moodle on hostinger.com. I'll start by logging into my account. And from the menu on the top, I'll choose Websites. And we want to create a new website. So we need to click on Start Now. But I don't want any personalized experience, and I'll just create an empty website at the moment. I already have a domain, so I'll use an existing domain. And here we need to type in the name of the domain that we want to use for this new website. In my case, I'm going to use moodle.absprog.com. And let's click on continue. And once again. And we need to choose the location for the server. Generally speaking, try to choose something that's as close as possible to your client, to the people who will use this website. You can choose anything from this list, but for this demonstration, I just leave it with the default option. And let's finish setup. Okay, and the new website was created. And now we need to connect our domain to this website. So let's click on connect. And here we need to choose a provider. Of course, they only have a few domain companies on this list, but it doesn't really matter which one you choose. I'll go with other. And let's click let's start. Now I manage my domains in AWS by Amazon. So here is what we need to do, and it's going to be very similar if you use any other company to manage your domains. So as you can see, this is the management screen for this website, absprog.com, and we want the new website to be a subdomain of this domain. So we need to create a new record, and here I'll just go with simple routing, and we need to define a record. Now, as you can see in their instructions, what we need to change is the name servers. So to change the name servers, we need an NS record. So let's get back to AWS, and the record type is going to be NS. Here it is, NS name server. And in this box, I need to provide the values that Hostinger provides. So from here, I'm going to copy this address and paste it. And I'll also copy this address and paste it as well. And of course, we need to specify the subdomain. And this record will be applied to this subdomain. So let's define the record and let's create it. We now need to wait about a minute or so. Okay, so I waited for about a minute, and let's get back to Hostinger and continue. Okay, so we're done with that, and we can move on to manage site. The next thing we need to do is get the Moodle software. So let's go to moodle.org, and here I'll choose downloads, and here is the latest Moodle version 4.2.2. And we need to download the zip file. Okay, so it's being downloaded. Now, back in Hostinger, let's open the file manager. We can do it either from here or from the menu on the left. So here, files and file manager. And let's access the files of our website. And I'm simply going to drag here the zip file we just downloaded. And the zip file is being uploaded. It's quite a big file, so it will take a minute or two. Okay, and the zip file was uploaded. We now need to extract its content. So let's choose it. And here we have the extract option. So let's extract. And here we have to provide the name of a folder. So I'll call it temporary. And here I choose public HTML and extract. Okay, so the zip file was extracted, and if we now open the public HTML folder, we can see here our temporary folder. So let's get into this folder, and here we have the Moodle folder. Let's get into it as well. And I'm going to select all of the files here with Ctrl A, and we're going to move the files, so move, and we want them directly in the public HTML folder. So one level up, and another level up. And here is where we want them, inside public HTML, so move. And as you can see, all of these files are now directly under the public HTML folder. Let's now try to access our new Moodle website. And now we can start the Moodle installation itself. We need to choose a language. I'll go with English. And as you can see here, Moodle is going to create a new folder that's called Moodle Data. This folder is going to be in the same level as public HTML. So let's click on Next. And if we open the file manager again and get back to the home folder, we can see that we now have here a new folder, Moodle Data, in addition to public HTML. Now we need to choose the type of the database. Hostinger.com uses MariaDB, so that's what I'm going to choose. And next. And now we need to provide the database name, a database user, and a password. So let's get back to our website manager. And now from the menu on the left, I'm going to choose databases and management. And as you can see, there is a prefix here that we cannot change, but we do need to provide a name for the specific database that we want, and I just call it Moodle. As for the MySQL username, I leave it as admin. Let's now provide a password, and Hostinger can help us create a password. So I'll click here, and here is a password. And let's create the database. And I can now copy the name of the database and paste it. And let's also copy the database user. And we're also going to need our password. And let's click on Next. We need to confirm the conditions. And here we can see that we have something red. The problem is that we're missing a PHP extension, specifically the Sodium extension. So let's get back to our website management tool, and under Advanced, I'm going to choose PHP configuration. Here I choose PHP extensions, and if we scroll down a bit, we can see Sodium over here. So let's check its box and save. And let's get back to our Moodle website. And let's scroll to the very bottom and click on Reload. And you can see that now everything is green. So let's continue. And the setup is complete, so Moodle itself is being installed. And it's done, and let's click on Continue again. We now need to provide a Moodle admin user. I'll call it admin. And we also need to provide a password for the admin user. We need to provide the first name and the last name for this user, and an email address, and update profile. Let's give a name to our website. And here we can either enable or disable self-registration, which will allow users to register themselves. I'm going to leave it as disabled. This is a support email that your users can use if they run into problems. And let's save the changes. And in this page, we can register our website, but we don't really have to. If we don't want to register, we can skip. And our Moodle website is up and running. And the last thing we need to take care of is cron jobs. So let's get back to our website manager. And here from Advanced, I'm going to choose cron jobs. Now, if we get back to our file manager, we can open public HTML, and here admin, CLI, and here we have cron.php. This is the script that needs to be run periodically. Public HTML, admin, CLI, and then cron.php. So that's what I'm going to type in. But we also have to allow the execution permission to this file. So here, I'm going to choose the file cron.php, and I'm going to change its permissions. And I'll add the execute permission for the owner and for the group. And let's update. And all that's left is to register this cron job. So we need to choose how often we want the script to run. So for minutes, I'll go with every other minute, which basically means every 2 minutes. And for the rest of the options, I'll go with star. So this way, this file will run every 2 minutes. And let's save this cron job. And now we need to get back to our website. and we need to choose site administration. And we want to check if the cron job actually runs. So to do that, I choose server, and from tasks, we're going to choose scheduled tasks. Now, many of the options here are disabled, so their last run will be never. But you want to make sure that not all of them show never. So there have to be at least some of them that show some other value. And as you can see here, I do see something that's different than never. If I do see values that are different than never, it means that the cron job was set up correctly. Once you're done with that, you can get back to the home page and start adding courses to your Moodle website.